effects on IQ. I know this has been a key part of your research and the Little Things Matter video, which we shared with our customers and consultants a number of years ago. And it was really eye-opening. I'm wondering, can you just kind of walk us through that graph and that concept of, again, this idea that making those little changes both can be part of the problem, or I think conversely, it can be part of the cure as well.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, this idea that little shifts matter is kind of an odd one for most of us to get our heads around. We want to rather find those big risk factors that cause, you know, 100% of the problem or 90% of the problem. But I think more likely, whether it's preterm birth or whether it's IQ deficits or whether it's many types of cancer, it's the cumulative impact of many subtle risk factors that result in disease. And so while it would be appealing to tackle one thing, it really is more than that. The other thing that really I think is powerful is this idea that when you shift the curve, you may only see, let's say, a 5 IQ point decrement. And for one child, that can seem substantial. But if I'm just looking at two children, I couldn't necessarily tell the difference between a child with an IQ of 105 and 100. But if I shift the IQ of the entire U.S. population, it has huge magnification of its impact. For example, every year there's 4 million children born in the United States. And if we look at the impact of low-level lead exposure in the past, it shifted the entire IQ by 5 points. That means there are 57% more children who have an IQ below 70. And those children, when they grow up, will find it harder to contribute to society, may need more educational services. And overall, for each IQ point they lose, they will have about $20,000 less in lifetime earnings. Now again, $20,000 may not seem like a whole lot, but magnify that by 4 million children born every year for how many decades, right? We had this lead epidemic for decades. It puts us at a disadvantage compared to other countries if you're into that kind of a competition. But the other thing to recognize, of course, and this happens consistently, is we, even once we reduce exposures to something like lead in North America, the industries that sold lead to us shift their marketing strategy, and now they sell it to Southeast Asia and Africa. And so now 80 to 90% of kids around the world who are lead poisoned lived in low to middle income countries. And that is just as tragic as what happened to us here, is that we failed to learn from those mistakes, and now we're watching it happen elsewhere.
Well, I think that's well said, and something we might not recognize, that there's a downstream effect. Talk upstream, but now there's a downstream effect from the actions that we're taking today too.